cars burned, shop windows shattered, establishments looted. Like many cities across the nation, Florida has seen its share of violent protests as people continue to take to the streets in indignation over the death of George Floyd, an unarmed black man, while in police custody. 12 counties in the Sunshine State imposed emergency curfew orders Sunday in response to the growing civil unrest to protect its citizens. Brick and mortar businesses, including restaurants, are required to close by 10 p.m. On Monday, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis broke his silence to address the death of Floyd and the protests that broke out across Florida. DeSantis said Florida has zero tolerance when it comes to violence, riots, and looting. But he also took time to call Floyd's murder appalling, saying the Minnesota officers involved should be brought to justice. Meanwhile, Phil-Am business owner Darren Mendoza said that both his Filipino restaurants in Pembroke Pines and in Miami, Florida, have just reopened a week ago, and that the mandatory curfew is already impacting his business that has yet to recover from the COVID-19 pandemic.
We're open 50%, but since these things happen, I'm forced to close early because, of course, merong ano, may curfew. So with the pandemic and the curfew alone is destroying our business.
Mendoza added that the violent protesters are a detriment to the U.S. economy's recovery.
I think that's their plan. It's just to get items from other or destroy businesses for their own goods.
While there were violent confrontations between police officers and demonstrators in South Florida, several peaceful protests, like this one in Northern Florida, were held.
I am amazed at the turnout. This is just proof that we all care. Pensacola cares, Minneapolis.
Officials in Florida counties have yet to give the exact date when the curfews will be lifted. Paul Garilao, ABS-CBN News, Florida.